My name is Mary Brown, and I serve as an associate pastor at Colonial Presbyterian Church in Kansas City. I lead the Discipleship Initiative for the Well Women's Resources within the Evangelical Presbyterian Church. Let me tell you about the exciting things that are happening within women's ministry in the Evangelical Presbyterian Church. In 2015, we gathered one woman representing their presbytery for our denomination. That became the Women's Resource Council. We focused our attention on creating General Assembly events and discipleship and leadership resources, providing women a way to help other women grow spiritually. We wanted a grassroots connectional model with a web page so that women throughout our nation can connect and share what God is doing in their local context. The Well has a vision to empower women to begin those spiritual conversations with their neighbors, family members, coworkers, and then take that next step in engaging in reading God's word with them so that they can grow spiritually. It develops a mentoring model similar to Jesus himself and recorded in God's word. Women teaching other women sound doctrine and how to live in obedience to God's will. It is our hope and prayer at the Well that women begin these conversations, dig into God's word with another woman, take them under their wing and help them grow spiritually, then integrate them into the local church. So how would you begin a mentoring ministry in your local church? Check out our tips on the discipleship page of the Well Women's Resources at epc.org. First, pray and ask God for guidance. Then identify women who would be good mentors, those women who love God, who love God's word and love his church. Those women will be encouraged to look around their sphere of influence for those women who are spiritually open and ready to dig into God's word. Then invite those potential mentors to study one of the resources listed under Starting a Mentoring Ministry. The goal is to make disciples and fulfill the Great Commission. Go and make disciples. What is a disciple? A disciple is someone who takes the teachings of Jesus and the commands of God and puts them into practice. It's about obedience and following the will of God. So how do we do that? Learn the teachings of Jesus and God's commands and learn to live them out. I'm going to say we learn them best either in a one-on-one relationship or a fairly small group of women where we consistently read God's word and then learn to live in obedience to Jesus Christ. Then shares their life of faith with another woman or a group of women. I want to tell you the story about how I was mentored. I became a believer at age 35. Shortly after I surrendered my life to Jesus Christ, my coworker came up to my desk and invited me to be a part of her prayer group that met before work. I told her yes. She walked away from my desk and I'm thinking to myself, I don't even know how to pray, so how can I be a part of her prayer group? I went up to her and I told her, I can't participate in your prayer group. And she said, why don't you join us? And if you agree with what we're praying, just tell God that you agree. And then when you're ready to pray yourself, just join us in prayer. I thought to myself, I can do that. I became a part of that prayer group. And then this began an informal, intentional, one-on-one discipling relationship between Julie and I, where over lunch, she would explain to me things that I was learning from God's word and sharing with me how to follow Jesus in my everyday life. So how did Jesus make disciples? Basically, he called 12 men and he said, come follow me. And then he took those 12 men and he taught them with such authority. He taught them dependence upon the Father through prayer. He taught them how to cast out evil spirits. He taught them about his own power in doing miracles and healings. Then what he did is he took those 12 and he sent them out to make disciples themselves. He trained and equipped them and then sent them out. Then he sends out 72 others, trained and equipped disciples to make other disciples. Jesus trained, taught, and equipped his disciples and then sent them out to find those who were spiritually open. The 12 and the 72 were learning the commands of God and then putting them into practice. So the way Jesus did it is basically, go. Go make disciples. Now what's happening in the local church is we're saying, come. It's more a attractional model where we say, come, come to us. Come to our Sunday morning worship experience. Come to our Sunday school class and learn. But what it's lacking is that one-on-one or that small group intentional relationship for spiritual growth. The process of making disciples is so unique and specifically tailored to the individual that we should not use a cookie-cutter approach in teaching people the art of disciple-making. Each person is created unique in the image of God, and we need to listen to their specific needs as they learn obedience in following Jesus. That is why at The Well, we give specific categories of resources in which you can select the best resources for your specific mentoring relationship. This is the key. Disciple making is relational at its very core. I would venture insofar as to say that every person needs a mentoring relationship to help them spiritually grow. Our faith is anchored in God's Word, and the Holy Spirit affirms what God reveals to us. Let me tell you about my trip to India. It really was life-changing. We did women's conferences, and during one part of the conference where hundreds of women would be gathered in a room, the leader of this ministry asked all women who were willing to share their faith in Jesus Christ with other women in their village to check a box on a piece of paper. And then if they were willing to disciple whoever they led to Christ for 1 year, to check another box. Then during part of their worship experience, all women who were willing to do those two things raised the paper. To my amazement, all the women in the room raised their sheet of paper. And at a commissioning service, those women were willing to share their faith in Christ and disciple another woman. I looked at my friend and I said, we need to do this in America. The Well wants to help you get started in this kingdom-building ministry in your local church. It is our hope that women all around our country share stories about what God is doing in His church. We have provided on our webpage and through social media tools a place for women to find appropriate resources for their mentoring relationships and to share their stories with other women around the country. There are four general categories of vetted resources. Believe. These resources assist us in growing spiritually in faith. Belong. They will help you develop Christ-centered relationships. Be bold. Geared toward reaching out through evangelism and missions. Be free. These resources help us in finding freedom and healing. Check out The Well Facebook page and blog to see what is happening around the country with women in local churches just like yours. At The Well, we want to make it simple for you to be disciples that make disciples for God's glory. We would love to see a disciple-making movement happen in all of our local churches. So join us in making disciples for God's glory.